الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صلِّ وسلِّم وبارك على سيدنا محمد النبي الأمي وآله وصحبه. أما بعد، my dear brothers and sisters, my dear children and grandchildren, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Today, inshallah, I will continue my talk regarding Muhammad, alayhi salatu wassalam, the messenger, the prophet, the human, alayhi salatu wassalam. I stopped last week at verse 107, chapter 21, Surah Al-Anbiya, the prophets. And the verse, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. O Muhammad, we have not sent you except as a mercy to all the worlds. If you read Surah Al-Fatiha, the first chapter in the Quran, we say, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. And we refer here, Allah is saying, we are supposed to be saying, praise be to Allah, Rabb, the Lord, the Sustainer, the Cherisher, Al-Alameen, all the worlds. So let us concentrate on the worlds of Allah first. So here we talk about عالم الإنس, عالم الجن, عالم الروح, عالم الملائكة, الملأ الأعلى, and so on. The world of the dead, the world of the ins, the world of the jinn, the world of the angel, the highest assembly, the world of the spirit, the world of the unbelievers, the hypocrites. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the Lord and sustainer of all these worlds. And then Allah is telling us He sent to Muhammad to all these worlds as a mercy. The only one, alayhi salatu wasalam, to all these worlds. So Muhammad, as I mentioned last week, mercy to the ins, the jinn, the angels, the world of the dead. And when you use the word rahmah, Allah refers, I mean, you need to listen very carefully to how miser and stingy we are when even it comes to show mercy towards each other. Allah says this, that's what He says. So in Surah Al-Isra, chapter 17, verse 100, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. قل لو أنتم تملكون خزائن رحمة ربي إذا لأمسكتم خشية الإنفاق وكان الإنسان قطورا. Tell them, Muhammad, even if you owned the treasures of my Lord's mercy, you would have held them back for fear of spending them. Why? Man is indeed ever niggardly. Say, had you possessed the treasures of my Lord's mercy, you would have withheld them for fear of spending them. How miserly is man? Can you imagine if we had the keys of the treasures of the mercy of Allah, we wouldn't have showed any mercy towards each other. Can you imagine? And I mentioned last week, any act which lacks mercy is not from Islam. And do you know that one of the attributes or the qualities of those who will get their book in the right hand on the day of judgment, those who used to enjoy mercy, those who used to say to each other, be merciful to your wife, be merciful to your children, be merciful to your husband, be merciful to the animals, the kingdom, the world, the sea world, or animal kingdom, whatever, animal world. So just by saying to someone, be kind, be merciful, you have reached an attribute of those who will have the book by the right hand in the hereafter. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Balad, chapter 17, ثُمَّ كَانَ مِنَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالصَّبْرِ وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالْمَرْحَمَةِ. And then beside this, he be one of those who believed and enjoined upon one another patience, perseverance, and enjoined upon one another rahmah, compassion, mercy. Can you imagine just by saying to someone, please, be kind, be merciful, you have qualified to receive your book in your right hand on the day of judgment. So let us concentrate on the word rahmah. Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam, rahmah lil alamin. Now, in the next verse 45, chapter 33, Surah Al-Ahzab, Ya ayyuha an-nabi, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking to the Prophet. He used to call, Ya ayyuha al-rasul, Ya ayyuha an-nabi. Every rasul is nabi, but not every nabi is rasul. You need to understand that. Every messenger is a rasul, is a messenger and a prophet. But not every prophet is a messenger. Ya ayyuha an-nabi. Allah is calling Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam. Oh prophet, inna arsalnaka shahidan wa mubashiran wa nadhira. We have sent you shahid to act as a witness. وَمُبَشِّرًا to give glad tidings, good news, وَنَذِيرًا to warn against evil. So here we have three attributes again of the Prophet: شاهد, بشير, نذير. وَدَاعِيًا إِلَى اللَّهِ بِإِذْنِهِ وَسِرَاجًا مُنِيرًا, and one who invites to the way of Allah by his permission. Not everyone has this right. Allah gave Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam as a messenger, as a prophet, وَدَاعِيًا إِلَى اللَّهِ بِإِذْنِهِ, and as one who invites to Allah's grace by his leave, by his permission, by his command. وَسِرَاجًا مُنِيرًا. Let us try to understand the two attributes, siraj and munir. Again, one of the attributes of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam is siraj, and the other one is munir. When Allah refers to the sun in the Quran, He refers to it as sirajan wahaja, a lamp which is shining with light, burning light. The sun is a star, the nearest star to earth. It's a burning body. And when He refers to the moon, وَجَعَلَ الْقَمَرَ ضِيَاءً, munir. Al-Qamar is a cold light. It's the reflection of the light of the sun on the moon. So it doesn't hurt. It doesn't burn. But the sun burns and the moon doesn't. So Muhammad alayhi salam combined the two. But what does Allah say? Sirajan munira. Muhammad, you are a siraj, yes, but you don't burn. You are like the light of the moon, which is cold, but at the same time you are the sun and the moon. So Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam, the sun and the moon. But he is the sun which doesn't burn. وَسِرَاجًا مُنِيرًا. Siraj, munir. And immediately after that, Allah says, وَبَشِّرِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. Oh Muhammad, give glad tidings to the believer. Now we started by saying, إِنَّ أَرْسَلْنَاكَ شَهِدًا وَمُبَشِّرًا وَنَذِيرًا. So now we see the bushra, the glad tidings, the good news. Oh Muhammad, what good news did you bring? وَبَشِّرِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. Give the believers good tidings, glad tidings, good news. بِأَنَّ لَهُم مِّنَ اللَّهِ فَضْلًا كَبِيرًا. They are going to receive a great reward, a great bounty from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let me read some of the footnotes. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was sent by Allah in five capacities. There are mentioned in this verse and the other two in the verse following. He comes as a witness to all people about the spiritual truth which had been obscured by ignorance or superstition or by the dust of sectarian controversy. He did not come to establish a new religion or sect. Muhammad came to restore the religion of Ibrahim. ثُمَّ أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَيْكَ أَنْ اتَّبِعْ مِلَّةَ إِبْرَاهِيمَ حَنِيفًا وَمَا كَانَ مِنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ. Muhammad came to restore the religion of Ibrahim after the corruption which went into Christianity and Judaism. Just as simple as that. He came to teach religion. He is also a witness to Allah about men's doings and how they receive Allah's message. Secondly, he comes as a bearer of the glad tidings of the mercy of Allah. No matter how far men may have transgressed, they have hope if they believe, repent, and live a good life. This is something so beautiful. When Muhammad is telling us, if you believe, if you behave, you'll be forgiven. We are all sinners. But the best among the sinners are those who would repent and adjust their conduct. So Muhammad told us that. If you do something wrong, say sorry. Sincerely, Allah would forgive you and replace your evil deeds by good deeds. And you start again on a clean slate. Just as simple as that. Thirdly, he also comes as a warner to those who are heedless. This life will not last. We all know this. Alhamdulillah, I'm counting now how many days are left. Khalas, khalas. Whatever has gone, has gone. Whatever is left, we must invest it properly. Make sure it's not going to be wasted as the previous moments which we wasted already. This life will not last. There is a future life. And that's all important. The two other capacities in which the Prophet was sent are here specified. Four, he comes as one who has a right to invite all people to repentance and the forgiveness of sins. But he does this not of his own authority, but by the permission and authority given to him by Allah. This is said lest people may defy the Prophet as they did with other prophets before him. The personal responsibility of each individual remains, but the Prophet can lead him on the right and help him. So this is the role of the Prophet here, alayhi salatu wasalam. Five, the Prophet also comes as a light or a lamp, siraj, to illuminate the whole world, alayhi salatu wasalam. Nur, nur al-Nabi, alayhi salatu wasalam. From nur al-Quran, from the light of the Quran. And elsewhere, the same word siraj, as I mentioned earlier, used for the sun. The compassion is apt. When the sun appears, all lesser lights pale before its light. And the message of Islam, i.e. of the universal religion, is to diffuse light everywhere. So these were some of the attributes of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam: Shahid, Bashir, Nadir, Siraj, Munir, and so on. In Surah Saba, chapter 34, verse 28. Could you please move forward? Stand up, please. Fill the gaps. Please complete the front rows. There is more reward in the front rows than in the... So in verse 28, chapter 34, what does Allah say about the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam? وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا كَافَّةً لِلنَّاسِ. O Muhammad, we have sent you as a messenger to all the people. Musa came to his own people, to Bani Israel, and Isa the same. But Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam came as a messenger to all the people. As I mentioned before, he was mentioned in the Torah and in the Gospel. They were told. Musa was told, Isa was told, alayhim as-salatu wasalam, that Muhammad is coming. So Muhammad, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا كَافَّةً لِلنَّاسِ. To do what? Bashiran wa nadhira. Again, to give them glad tidings, to tell them if they do wrong and repent, I will forgive them. Wa nadhiran, to warn them against the punishment for their sins and the hellfire. ولكن أكثر الناس لا يعلمون. Allah is saying, but unfortunately, the majority of the people they don't know. Unfortunately, the majority of the world today, secular world. Sorry to say that, but this is reality. Unfortunately, we are moving away. Christians already moved away from their book. Jews did the same. Muslims are doing exactly the same, following the footsteps of the Jews and the Christians. We are moving away from the Quran, from Allah's moral law, from the tradition of the Prophet alayhi salatu wassalam. Completely. Unfortunately. So we have not sent you but a messenger to all mankind, giving them glad tidings and warning them against sin. But most people do not know, unfortunately. And in Surah Al-A'raf, chapter 7, قُلْ يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسِ, verse 158, قُلْ يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسِ, O Muhammad, say, O people, إِنِّي رَسُولُ اللَّهِ إِلَيْكُمْ جَمِيعًا. I am the messenger of Allah to all of you. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in an authentic hadith, بلغوا عني ولو آية. We are the messengers of the messenger. We are رسول رسول الله. Each one of you, each one of us, is the messenger of the messenger. And what did he say to us? بلغوا عني ولو آية. Deliver on my behalf even one single verse. Can you imagine? One verse from the whole of the Quran. قل يا أيها الناس إني رسول الله إليكم جميعا. Say, O people, I am sent unto you all as the messenger of Allah. Who is he? الذي له ملك السماوات والأرض. لا إله إلا هو يحيي ويميت. Attributes of Allah, the one who has the kingdom of the heavens and the earth. The one who gives life and causes death. فآمنوا بالله ورسوله النبي الأمي. Here you hear the word النبي الأمي. فآمنوا بالله. The command, Allah is saying, so believe in Allah and His messenger, النبي الأمي, the unlettered prophet who could neither read nor write. If he would have read and written, we would have doubted, or the people even would have doubted his message more, because Muhammad could neither read nor write. The revelation he received challenged Quraysh, challenged the Arabs who were pioneers in poetry and Arabic literature. That was the miracle of Muhammad. The Quran is the miracle of Muhammad. Nobody could produce even one single ayah when Allah challenged them. Bring a book like this. Okay, bring 10 surah. Okay, just bring one surah. Three verses. And they couldn't. They were pioneers in Arabic literature. And he couldn't. Muhammad, who could neither read nor write, brought this revelation to convince them it is from Allah. It's not from him. He couldn't neither read nor write. He did not read any divine revelation before him. He did not read the Bible or the Gospel or the Psalms of David. And he couldn't write. So why do you accuse him of forging it? And Allah says, الَّذِي يُؤْمِنُ بِاللَّهِ وَكَلِمَاتِهِ, the prophet who believes in Allah and His words. وَاتَّبِعُوهُ, follow Him. لَعَلَّكُمْ تَهْتَدُونَ. Oh, how beautiful it is. Follow Him that you may be guided. Follow Him in His character, in His conduct, in the way He treated His wives, in the way He treated the orphans and the needy and the poor and the helpless and the widows. Follow Him. Don't devour the inheritance. Don't take your mother's share, your sister's share. Don't ill-treat the orphans. Feed the poor and the needy. It's a great quality to give food to those who are hungry. I saw a van yesterday. I was very surprised. In front of me, and on the van was written, we provide food free of charge. We don't ask for any financial assessment, just to pop in and take whatever you want. And I think we should do this in this mosque. We should have a food bank outside here or in the basement. We should do that. We should provide food. There are many poor people in the community, Muslim, non-Muslim, it doesn't matter. You are allowed to feed the non-Muslims from your zakah money. Can you imagine? Yes, to attract them to Islam. So hopefully, inshallah, in the next trustees meeting, maybe we will be able to discuss how can we provide an ongoing supply of food to the poor and the needy. We are a charity. And alhamdulillah, we have a lot of donors who are very generous. And we would like to use some of this money to feed the poor and the needy in our community here, to advertise it and make sure people, that doesn't matter how much they will take it. People are taking it to eat. They are hungry. Things are becoming very expensive, unfortunately. Especially, employment is becoming very difficult among our people as well, among our communities. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, let me read the full verse in English. Say, O people, I am sent unto you all as a messenger of Allah, to whom belongs the dominion of the heavens and the earth. There is no God but He. It is He that gives both life and death. So believe in Allah and His messenger, the unlettered prophet, who believes in Allah and His words. Follow Him that you may be guided. In Surah Al-Ahzab, again, chapter 33, verse 21. 21, yes. Listen, لقد كان لكم في رسول الله أسوة حسنة. You have indeed in the messenger of Allah an excellent exemplar, an excellent example to follow. لقد كان لكم في رسول الله أسوة حسنة. What is the difference between أسوة and قدوة? قدوة, I can learn from you and you can learn from me. أسوة, I can only learn from you. So Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam, we are not qudwa for him. No, he is uswa for us. We learn from him. If we follow him, we learn from him. لقد كان لكم في رسول الله أسوة حسنة. You have indeed in the messenger of Allah an excellent example to follow. لمن كان يرجو الله واليوم الآخرة وذكر الله كثير. These are three things which Muhammad عليه الصلاة والسلام used to do, and Allah is saying, follow him, learn from him. He is your أسوة. What are the three things? لمن كان يرجو الله واليوم الآخر وذكر الله كثيرا. For him who hopes in Allah and the final day, and he remembers Allah much. Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam, he had these three things, and Allah is saying, follow him, learn from him. Yarju Allah, do you seek the forgiveness of Allah? Do you seek the pleasure of Allah? Do you reflect on the moment when you will stand in front of him on your own? Nobody will help you. And he's going to question you, and you are going to be held accountable for everything you did or said in this life. So here you are thinking of Allah and the final day. وَذَكَرَ اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا. Muhammad used to remember Allah so much. عليه الصلاة والسلام. And you remember when Musa عليه الصلاة والسلام asked Allah for so many things, and then he said, كي نذكرك كثيرا. So موسى عليه الصلاة والسلام, after he asked, رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي واجعل لي وزيرا من أهلي, هارون أخي أجدد به أزري وأشركه في أمري كي نسبحك كثيرا ونذكرك كثيرا إنك كنت بنا بصير. Oh Allah, I'm asking for all these things, so I'm going to remember you as much as I can, all the time, and praise you all the time. فاذكروني أذكركم. Remember me, I remember you. And be grateful and say thank you. I think it's written over there, yes? On the wall there, yes? Who can read it? Can you read it? What does it say? فاذكروني أذكركم واشكروا لي ولا تكفرون. Remember me, I remember you, and be grateful and say thank you. Yeah. That was the أسوة محمد عليه الصلاة والسلام. In Surah Al-Ahzab, again, 33, and this is verse 40. ما كان محمد أبا أحد من رجالكم. Muhammad is not the father of any of you. ولكن رسول الله وخاتم النبيين. I'm going to put a little stress here on the word خاتم. محمد, and the revelation or the reason for the revelation here to nullify the custom of adoption in Islam. No adoption. I can foster someone, I cannot adopt. I'm not going to take a child who is not my biological child, give him my name, give him my inheritance, allow him to mix freely among my in my house with my daughter, my biological daughter, my biological sons, no, or with my wife, no. So Muhammad took Zayd ibn Haritha as his own son, and Allah is saying, "Ma kana Muhammadun aba ahadin min rijalikum." Muhammad is not the father of any of your men. Walakin, but he is رسول الله. He is the messenger of Allah. وخاتم النبيين. خاتم. When you seal a document, we call it خت. In Arabic, ختم. So Muhammad is the last prophet. If anyone claims there is a new prophet, he committed blasphemy because Muhammad is the last and final prophet. خلاص. And you know, there are some, unfortunate to say, some groups who claim there's a man called XYZ, he is the last, he's a new prophet. I'm not going to mention any names, but you know what I'm talking about. So Muhammad, Rasulullah, wa khatam al-Nabiyin, khalas. No more prophets after Muhammad. And no more messages after Muhammad, khalas. Finished. Wa kana Allah bi kulli shay'in alima. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has full knowledge of all things. Footnote 1731. When a document is sealed, it is complete. And there can be no further addition. The Holy Prophet Muhammad closed the long line of messengers. Allah's teaching is and will always be continuous. But there has been and will be no prophet after Muhammad. This must be made very clear, please. I don't want the minds of young Muslims to be corrupt by thinking or believing. Yeah, why not? Allah can, well, this man is a prophet, this man. No, no. The later ages will want thinkers and reformers, not prophets. This is a very interesting point. The later ages will want thinkers and reformers, not prophets. This is not an arbitrary matter. It is a decree full of knowledge and wisdom, for Allah has full knowledge over all things. Just as simple as that. So please, and I say this to the young Muslims here, Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam, Rasulullah wa khatam al-Nabiyyin. Remember the word khatam, please, the seal of all the prophets. In verse 28, chapter 48, Surah Al-Fath. Muhammadun Rasulullah. Statement by Allah at the beginning of verse or starting, let me start from verse 28 to give you more information about. هو الذي أرسل رسوله بالهدى ودين الحق. هو refers to Allah. It is He, سبحانه وتعالى, who sent His messenger بالهدى, guidance, the Quran, ودين الحق, and the religion of truth. I have a son-in-law who was a German Catholic, and he embraced Islam and married my daughter. My wife took him for Hajj with our daughter, and he called me from there, from Mecca, from the Kaaba. He said, Papa, this is the true religion. This is the right religion. What he saw made him fully convinced that this is the true religion. He came from a Catholic family who were practicing Catholicism. But when he saw the truth, and Allah says, when you go for Hajj, لِيَشْهَدُوا مَنَافِعَ لَهُمْ, to witness benefits for them. So every time I read any of the verses which talks about Deen al-Haq, the religion of truth, I remember what Matthias said to me while he was performing his Hajj. This is the true religion. This is the right religion. He felt it. We as Muslims, we've been born in Muslim families. So we don't have this feeling, you know. But people who come into the religion willingly and they see the truth, they declare it to everyone. And that's how we should feel. This is the true religion. What are you arguing about? How dare would you question Allah regarding any commands or any orders in the Holy Quran? How dare would you question Him? محمد رسول الله والذين معه. Now we are going to talk about those who are with Him. What qualities have they got? أشداء على الكفار رحماء بينهم. Let me start again from verse 28. So I prepare you mentally for this. والذي أرسل رسوله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله وكفى بالله شهيدا. It is He who has sent His messenger with guidance and the religion of truth to make it prevail over all religion. And enough is Allah for a witness. خلاص, if Allah is the witness. وكفى بالله شهيدا. محمد رسول الله. محمد is the messenger of Allah. والذين معه أشداء على الكفار رحماء بينهم. This is so beautiful. محمد is the messenger of Allah, and those who are with him are strong against unbelievers, but compassionate among each other. رحماء بينهم. If you are really a follower of Muhammad, show mercy to each other, please. رحماء بينهم. Show mercy, please. Please. The divine disposition of events in the coming of Islam and its promulgation by the Holy Prophet are themselves evidence of the truth of Islam and its all-reaching character. For there is nothing which it has not influenced. The devotees of Allah wage unceasing war against evil for themselves and for others, but to their own brethren in faith, especially the weaker ones, they are mild and compassionate. They seek out every opportunity to sympathize with them and help them. I think this is very important. That if you are a follower of Muhammad, you should show mercy to all the others who are followers of Muhammad, especially those who are in need, those who are in help. Please. Especially the weaker ones, they are mild and compassionate. They seek out every opportunity to sympathize with them and help them. And Allah gave a parable in this verse because I have to stop in the next exactly 1 minute. Allah gave a parable here. I will read it very quickly. Muhammad is the messenger of Allah, and those who are with him are strong against unbelievers but compassionate amongst each other. You will see them bow and prostrate themselves in prayer, seeking grace from Allah and his good pleasure. On their faces are their marks, being the traces of their prostration. This is their similitude in the Torah, and their similitude in the gospel is like a seed which sends forth its blade, then makes it strong. It then becomes thick and stands on its own stem, filling the sowers with a wonder and delight. As a result, it fills the unbelievers with rage at them. Allah has promised those among them who believe and do righteous deeds forgiveness and a great reward. Next week, inshallah, when I continue the talk, I'm going to read this again, verses 28 and 29, chapter 48, Al-Fatih. I have two important announcements to make, but I will give the mic first to Brother Kaiser to finish, and then I will talk about the announcement. Thank you very much indeed for listening.